How long was this in the making? Are you suddenly flurrying out new announcements because everyone else has got one, or has this been something that you're building for a while?
I founded the company in 2015 when I realized that I was a CEO of a company here in New York City, and I realized that our people are spending like way too much time entering customer information like into our CRM system, and 99% of the work doesn't get done, and they hate it. So my thinking was, if AI can beat the world champion in chess, and if AI can diagnose cancer better than doctor, why it can't do all these like drudgery better than people? That was the idea for Gong, and that's what we started, and that's what we've been building ever since.
Okay, so if you've been building on these announcements, for example, since 2015, does it frustrate you that yesterday we had Twilio on discussing their generative AI, the day before everyone's got some latest announcement?
It excites me. Why would it frustrate it? When we started, it was a challenge to raise money because people didn't believe that AI can replace people's work. Now we don't have to prove that. Companies are coming. We need to reduce costs with AI. How can you help? So it actually provides like huge validation. We're excited. We think like every company is going to have something with AI. The question like, what are you doing with that? So it's actually super helpful and exciting.
To that point, what really got everyone realizing the potential of AI was, of course, ChatGPT, its unveiling in November and the iterations thereafter. Why are you basing it on your own generative AI models, your own proprietary data?
Great question. We have about 60 models. We also use OpenAI's model, which is great, but we have like special purpose models for almost everything, from understanding speech, from punctuating text, from summarizing, identifying action items, recommending people within an organization. So when you train specific model, you can get much higher accuracy and reliability rather than relying on public domain knowledge.
Hmm. Amit, have you already started thinking about efficiencies? And, you know, hard to ask, but eliminating roles at your company because of the impact that these tools will have?
70% of customer-facing time is wasted on non-productive work. It's things like updating record, internal meetings, sifting through records, and these are people that are making six figures. So it doesn't make sense to do all of the work. All along, we said AI can replace that, and our users love that they don't have to do this drudgery. They can spend more time with customers. So it doesn't necessarily mean like eliminating jobs, it means eliminating the drudgery from our day to day.
You talked about being sort of technology agnostic, 60 LLMs, I think you said that you were utilizing. But what's it like doing business with OpenAI? Is it good value for money for you, building something on top of GPT 3.5 or 4? I'm not sure what you use.
Yes, they've been a great partner. We've been working with them for over a year and allows early access to the latest stuff and allows us to use them for some of the applications. So it's been wonderful to work with, and we're excited that they're successful in helping prove to the world that AI is real and can make like a huge difference.
Since you've shown your hand in your competence of generative AI tools, how many of your investors have phoned you, asked if you should raise more money, asked about valuation? Do you have a higher valuation now that AI is attached to your business?
There, we've raised plenty of money. We've raised $600 million to date. Like even before AI was cool, people saw the user excitement and the value that Gong is creating. So we don't need to raise. We're not raising right now. We're actually not burning a ton of money. But definitely there is a ton of inbound interest. There's no shortage of people that want to invest, that they recognize the massive tectonic shifts that we're experiencing right now.
Amit, we came to you off a look at Adobe and the fact that they're willing to take some, well, legal risk on board. And we are beset with what are the ramifications of generative AI? What are the copyright? What is the bias? What is the negative repercussions? How do we regulate it? How are you thinking about that within your business?
AI is powerful and needs to be regulated. We put a lot of effort both on privacy, security, disclosure of information. Mm. So the system needs to be helpful. Mm. and not threatening to people, right? So everything is transparent, and I think like every company should put regulatory control, and I think both at the company level, but also at a country and a global level.